Hello and welcome to another episode of Thoughtful Leaders by CollegeDunya.com. Today we have with us Ms. Vani Kokila, who is the director at Sun International Tourism and Management, Hyderabad. So welcome to the show, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
And I would like to introduce you to our audience first. So Ms. Vani has post-graduated from New Hampshire University in Human Resources and UG in Psychology, IRPM. She has 12 years of experience in manufacturing and IT industry as a HR manager. Her specialization in psychology made it easier for her to become a certified trainer in Thomas International Psychometric Personnel in London. Her diversified experience over the decade in various fields has created an immense mark on her contributions to the society. With this brief introduction, I would welcome you to the show, ma'am. Yes, so I would like to start with my first question. Like, you have held key position at an educational institute throughout your professional career. So what are the key factors that keep you connected with the education sector?
Basically, thank you for the question, Sashi, and thank you for calling me as your guest and audition. I was totally into industry last almost more than 12 years, and that experience exposure gave me a lot of knowledge, and I'm completely aware of what industry needs. So depending on the industry needs, we have created the course, and this course, what we run in our college, is industry integrated program. Because generally the industry is expecting students to do something and education gives something else. That is where most of the students, when they go for interview, when they start working, industry will not accept them in the first stage because they feel that they have zero knowledge about the industry needs and requirements. So in our education, in our college, we have introduced this industry integrated program to give industry exposure experience during the education system. So that gives definitely edge over other students or other colleges, where the students' education will have mixture of the real-time practical oriented training kind of a thing during the education system. Yes.
That's great to know about your institute, ma'am. The next question would be, being the director at Sun International Institute of Tourism and Management, what is your philosophy of leadership? How do you describe your leadership style?
Basically, I think in education, there is no leadership. There is no leader. Education is imparting knowledge to everybody. If I actually feel like a leader, then I'm not a good director. So please I don't think so. Leadership, you don't need any leadership qualities in education system, especially. You should be a good team player. Obviously, as you say, even in the corporate sectors, you should be a good team leader. So leadership, I think everybody has leadership qualities, and I think in our college, more than me being a leader, we have to create leaders. That is more important. So we try to conduct a lot of events. We try to do a lot of, we try to give a lot of responsibilities to the students. And we try to ask people to ask more questions and, you know, do a lot of research and analysis so that they can become better leaders when they go to corporate sector. So when it comes to me, I don't consider myself as a big leader. I consider to be a good educator, a knowledge, I would like to share more knowledge, And I would like to be a very good counselor, because the age group is so volatile when they come to Sun College or any college in the sense it is a degree college. The student's age is between 18 and 21. And this is the age where students can become leaders, students can become drunkards, addicts, lot of things, love failures, you know, so many things. So, as a main person in the college, I ensure that students don't get into different kinds of things and they don't get easily depressed. You know, small things. I think these are very, very minute things where you have to overcome. So I think this is more important. As a director of the college, I would like to say that you should need a lot of patience to maintain such kind of atmosphere, environment in the college. And more than being a leader, you should be a listener. That is what I feel.
I completely agree with you on this, ma'am, because the students would definitely want a lot of guidance, as you just mentioned, and this is, I really agree with you on this. So my next question would be, the education systems in India and other foreign countries are structured very differently. In your experience, what can an inbound student gain from studying here in your institute?
As I earlier mentioned, the clear demarcation and the difference between any other college, and obviously I think we have copied a lot of international models, because I did my MBA with Manchester University, and then I did my psychology in the UK. That's when I got a lot of exposure, and I always felt that in other countries, in UK, US, they have less classes and more interactions and more industry knowledge. That is where India is missing. So India has more, like, parents, when they come, they ask, like, what are the times of the college? They want their students to study, to be in the, college from 9 to 5. No, ma'am, why it is 9 to 4? You keep it till 5, 6. They want their kids to be always in a cage, and then they ask, do you lock the door? All these things. I think we have to basically change our mindset of making students a little free, broader view, not that they have to sit from 9 to 5 and educate themselves. So I don't believe in, long classes and boring classes sometimes, because being as a student, I never wanted to sit for long hours in the class. So obviously this generation also definitely don't want to sit for long hours and listen to boring lectures always. Knowledge is there. So 45 days they go for industry exposure. They work. Everybody in our college, they work for 45 days. I put them in HR, marketing, sales, finance, accounts, chartered accountants, hotel industry, hotel management, tourism industry. And 45 days only they come to college. So when they come back to college, they are very fresh. Like, they come with fresh ideas. They are already into the team. They know how to behave with the boss. They know how not to behave with their boss. You always know, like, if you are a good employee, you want a good hire, you have to be very good with your boss. So in order, you know that fact in the young age. When you are in 18, 19 years, when you start working, you will understand all these things. It's not that you start afresh after after the degree. So this is a clear differentiation what Sun College has brought, and we wanted to tell the students that they should work. Everybody in our college works from the second semester, and by the end they go to the final semester, they are placed. They are placed with a lot of confidence, experience, exposure, and they also have a certificate in their hand. And more than that, they start earning from the second semester, which gives a lot of boost for the student to get into the employment. I think after the degree.
Definitely, ma'am, having a job in hand and getting the industry exposure from the second year itself is a great boost for the students. So based on this idea only, I would like to know, how does the curriculum of Sun International Institute of Tourism and Management ensure the best practice of industry?
I think the most of the questions are related to the same, like what I've answered in the previous question. The curriculum itself, we have drafted it as industry integrated. So every student has to work. It's a mandate that they work in different industries. Every semester they go to a different industry. For example, for BPA, maybe third semester they work in HR, fourth semester they work in finance, fifth semester they work with sharebroking agencies, sixth semester they can work in, you know, operations. Like every semester they can work in different fields. By the end of the semester, they will realize, like, okay, Sakshi as myself, what will I like that? Am I a good HR person? Am I a good sales or marketing person? Am I very good in numbers, accounts? So you will get a practical knowledge what Sakshi is all about. Like, what do I like? It's not that somebody is teaching you and then you will understand the concept. It is the person who goes in person to the organization, he or she will learn practically and will understand what is the industry all about, what is the particular subject all about, and what will I like. For example, because we are into hotel management, when the student works in service industry, service is serving. When he works in housekeeping, when he works in production, that is cooking. So practically, he will understand what the work is all about. By the end of the semester, he will understand maybe he is good in cooking, or he is good in housekeeping, or he is good in service. So he has better choice when he goes to the job, and then there are no regrets that, okay, I joined in finance department, but I'm very bad in numbers. You can't regret for it. So we give that chance in the beginning of the degree when you start. It's not that post degree you go and join in some, you know, vertical, and then you feel you don't like that. So that makes a lot of difference.
Definitely, ma'am, this is a very big step in their career, and they should be clear about which industry, like which department actually they are willing to join. With this, I would like to come to my next question. Like, when you first came to Sun International, what was your vision of the university? Has it evolved over time, and how far along in implementing that vision are you?
Yeah. I think we'll not talk vision, mission, all these statements we have wrote so many. When I was working with a lot of multinational companies, I worked for Honeywell, worked for Microsoft and other companies. It was a like 1 month session of writing a mission and vision. You know, in corporate sectors, it is very, very important to get into, you know, 5 years, then vision, then mission. But I think after I entered into this education field, my vision, mission, objective, goal, everything is only one. That is getting job for the student. Very simple. My vision is whoever joins in our college, when he goes out of the college, he should be employed. He should be employable. He should become an employee. So very simple vision. There is nothing, no jargons. No English, nothing. It is just that our vision from the Sun College is anybody who steps into the college, he should be employable. That is very clear, and I think you take it as objective, vision, goal, mission, whatever it is the same thing.
Definitely, ma'am. So what do you see as your institute's greatest strength?
Strength, I think we give an excellent environment here. I am very proud to say that we have excellent team, like my chairman Srikant Jasti, or my executive director Asha, myself and our faculty. We have around 150 faculty across Hyderabad and Visakhapatnam, and we should be very proud to say that we have super faculty who not only teaches, we make them into mentor. They are into, we have a concept called mentorship. So every 30 students, we have a mentor. That mentor is like a father and mother to that student. And since we are all from psychology background and counselors, we always train our faculty not only to teach, just to understand the students from personal and the academic view. There might be a student who is brilliant, but his personality or his attitude might be not so good to what the industry expects. It is our responsibility as the college to develop certain skills, make him understand what industry needs, not only professionally. I think personally, there will be so many students who are from different backgrounds and who come with a lot of depression. And this word, why I'm trying to tell you, you know, 2-3 times, because in the youth, I've observed, I think more than 25 to 30%, they are all depressed now. So we have to act very quickly because of different reasons, because of their personal financial reasons, personal reasons, family reasons. Everybody is coming from different backgrounds. So I think as mentors, we have to be back of them. And there are people who come from rural areas to Hyderabad and they develop new habits. They're habituated into different things. So I think as a college, we have to have that kind of empathy, ethics and values to create a good personality, not to get the 70-80% stand up and say that our college student is number one. Number one means is to 85%. So that is what we have our clear objective for, not only me. I think we should thank our faculty to have such kind of insight to develop and change the youth into what the industry.
Yes, so my next question to you, like not even a question, I would like to know if there is any message that you would like to give to the current youth and the aspiring students of your college, ma'am.
Message, I think people are bored to listen to too many messages. I'm not Abdul Kalam or Badr Khan to give any message. Only thing I wanted to say is any student who joins in undergraduation, that is degree course, I think your life is getting into a different change. Like you are getting into a different world, because till 12, you are into secured space and you know your parents are behind you and you are into school or college or Narayana Chaitanya, these kind of colleges are too secured. So once you can come into degree, so you get into a free world, so you have so many things to see, and you know you can get into good or bad, that is up to them in their own hands. So life is in your hands and you should take it up very seriously, and this undergraduation you have to take it up very seriously, because this is the stepping stone for the students, and you should get into industry focused more than, you know, studying. Develop nice personality skills, like a nice communication skills, ethics, don't please forget ethics and little bit of values, speak truth, that is more important. Very, very important thing for the student to know is, I always tell my students when they go for an interview, I tell them never lie in the interview, because your eyes, you know, speaks whether you are telling truth or you know, you're lying. So you never lie in the interviews, and definitely the other person will understand that, you know, you're a truthful guy. That is more important for any organization. To be employable, you have to be truthful. Only when I believe you, when I trust you, I will then take you as my employee. If I don't believe you, that's in the interview itself is gone. So be truthful to yourself and be truthful to anybody before you, and definitely success will run behind you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for this amazing message, ma'am. It was really thoughtful, and it is great to have you on the show, and thank you for sharing all the insights about Sun International Tourism and Management Institute. So I really thank you from the whole team of College Dunia as well for taking out your time and sharing such great insights. And that's it, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.